Bom dia from Cabo Verde. Welcome to this small island state at the Atlantic coast of Africa. I'm here in this beautiful country to research about the impacts of climate change and the relevant laws and policies in place to address them. Although Cabo Verde's share of global greenhouse gas emissions is less than 0.01%, it ranks as the 98th most vulnerable country to climate change. But before we dive into these issues, let's get to know the country a little better. You might be like me and have only heard of Cabo Verde in passing, perhaps as an up-and-coming beach getaway. Cabo Verde is made up of 10 volcanic islands and several islets. The capital city, Praia, is located on the largest island, Santiago. Cabo Verde has a population of 490,000 people, according to the 2021 census. In terms of land size, it's roughly 10 times smaller than Switzerland. Its maritime exclusive economic zone is around 182 times larger than its land area. The official language of Cabo Verde is Portuguese, and the Cabo Verdean Constitution also supports making Cabo Verdean Criollo an official language. Cabo Verdean Criollo is a unique Creole language that evolved from a mix of Portuguese and African languages. People use it every day to sing songs and to talk to each other with varying dialects across the islands. This Creole language represents centuries-long human migration to and from Cabo Verde. European sailors arrived here in 1456 to find the islands uninhabited by humans. The Portuguese crown took over, and Cabo Verde became the first European overseas colony. The Portuguese soon brought people from the West African coast who were enslaved. Over time, Cabo Verde became a hub for the transatlantic slave trade. Its position on trade routes between Africa, Europe, and America provided a strategic advantage. In 1975, Cabo Verde earned its independence. And since 1990, the country has embraced a multi-party democracy and a parliamentary regime marked by regular, fair, and free elections. Part 2 of Cabo Verde's constitution is dedicated to rights and freedoms. Article 73 guarantees the right to a healthy and ecologically balanced environment and everyone's duty to defend and conserve it. The state is primarily responsible for protecting the environment and natural resources. This makes Cabo Verde one of 156 United Nations member states that legally recognize the right to a healthy environment, even before global recognition by the UN Human Rights Council and the UN General Assembly. This brings us to climate change.
Cabo Verde is experiencing many environmental problems due to climate change and has faced a severe drought as well as sea level rises and loss of biodiversity and ecosystems, which present an existential threat to many archipelagos.
The Earth is already 1.1 degrees Celsius warmer than it was before industrialization. Here in Cabo Verde, people are noticing the effects mainly in three ways: intensified droughts, increased risk of flooding and coastal erosion, and sea level rise. These disasters interact with Cabo Verde's existing challenges and fragile ecosystem. Cabo Verde has no permanent water courses, no natural forests, limited mineral resources, and only 12% of its land is arable. The country relies heavily on imports for about 90% of its food. Potable water is also a major problem. Approximately 80% of the water consumed here comes from seawater desalination. This is a costly and energy-intensive process with significant environmental impacts. Recently, Cabo Verde has faced long periods of drought. When it rains, it's often torrential, causing floods that claim lives, especially in informal settlements in Praia. Government projects in collaboration with international partners are ongoing to manage these floodwaters. With 80% of the population living along the coast, rising seas impact almost everyone in Cabo Verde. Sea level rise poses an existential risk, especially for the low-lying islands of Sal, Boa Vista, and Mayo. Cabo Verde works with other countries to tackle environmental challenges. It's part of international treaties, including the Paris Agreement on Climate Change. The country's current climate goal is to achieve a carbon-neutral economy by 2050. By 2030, it aims to cut emissions by 18% or up to 24% with international support. Cabo Verde also plans to have over 50% of its electricity production come from renewable sources by 2030 and nearly 100% by 2040. But how will the country finance this transition? Cabo Verde relies highly on remittances and foreign aid to manage its external debt. Remittances come from an estimated 700,000 Cabo Verdeans living abroad, mainly in the US and Europe. Foreign aid typically comes from foreign governments and international organizations. The UNFCCC funds, such as the Green Climate Fund, are crucial sources for Cabo Verde's mitigation and adaptation projects. Cabo Verde is also pioneering new forms of finance, such as a debt for nature swap deal. Despite all the projects Cabo Verde embarks on, the real impact will ultimately be shaped by the actions of those in high-emitting countries. The future of Cabo Verde is filled with potential but remains uncertain. What happens next depends on all of us.